What's going on, Perform 24 family? Levi Jacob back in the garage, back with another video. And today we are going to be talking about rucking. Specifically, I'm going to be giving you 7 reasons why you might consider adding rucking to your training program. If you follow my content, specifically either on Instagram or on our monthly newsletter, you know that rucking has been kind of an obsession of mine over the last year or so. And so today I've kind of compiled the 7 reasons why I think it's practical for normal people like me and my clients to add a little bit of rucking to their fitness routine. So just to give you a little bit of context, I run a gym here in Tampa, Florida. It's called Perform 24. And first and foremost, I'm a coach. That's my actual job. The garage build stuff and the YouTube videos, that's kind of something that I do in addition to coaching and training people every single day. So these rucking tips are going to be for the everyday person, and I feel comfortable talking about that because I'm an everyday person and I work with everyday people every day. And I know that the home gym build kind of did put me on the YouTube map a little bit, and so if you own a home gym, I think rucking kind of falls right in line with that, and this is something that you could add to your home routine that could make a huge difference in the way you function and the way you feel. Okay, reason number one that I think rucking is practical is that it's progressive. There are a bunch of different variables that you can manipulate to fit your needs. And then you can progress those variables almost endlessly. Okay, so with rucking, you can manipulate your time, right? The amount of time that you're rucking. You can manipulate distance, how far you're rucking. You can manipulate frequency, how frequently throughout the week or throughout the month that you're rucking. And then obviously you can manipulate load. And so because there are all these different variables to play with, you can really kind of dial in on what your body needs and what's a challenge for you specifically. And I personally love this aspect of rucking. So I've used a little bit of rucking with a handful of clients at this point. Some of them were dealing with injuries, some of them needed to lose weight, and then some of them were looking for a little bit more movement in their weekly routine. And so rucking kind of fits those needs and fits those holes for a bunch of different people. The second reason that I've really started to believe in rucking is that it's kind of a body composition regulator. And so what I mean by that is that if you need to lose weight, you know, whether that's fat or muscle, I rarely run into that problem. But if you need to lose weight, rucking is going to help you lose weight. If you need to build strength, rucking is going to help you build strength. So it kind of, it almost brings people to a median, which I really, really like. I think for people that might be a little weak, rucking is going to build musculature and strength in your lower body, all in your legs and in your upper back. If those areas are weak, they are certainly going to be addressed during your rucking. So reason number 3 is going to play off of this concept on people that need to build strength. So rucking is going to expose deficiencies both in gait and in posture. So when you put that weight on your back, it's going to be pulling your spine back. It's going to be pulling your shoulders back. It's going to be bringing the load of your upper body directly over the top of your hips. And that load over the top of your hips as you're walking, your gait is going to have to accommodate for that heavier load on your back. So if you have bad gait, your gait is going to get exposed due to the load, right? If you have bad posture and you're putting a weight on your back, that posture is going to be exposed. Now, the reason that I like rucking and not just a weight vest is that the straps to the ruck are gonna pull your shoulders back just a little bit, and it's going to kind of lengthen and really stress like the erectors along your spine. And so, you know, I think rucking with straps and not necessarily a vest is a better option for most people. Whether that's a backpack like I use or even one of these like plate carriers, which I have a whole review on, but getting that load behind your back, I think is very, very important for postural and gait reasons. Okay, so reason number 4 is gonna be for those people that need to drop a few pounds. And there are a bunch of studies on this, so you don't necessarily have to take my word for this, but rucking burns 2 to 3 times more calories than just a regular walk. So if you're already walking your dog, or if you're walking your kids in a stroller around the block, throw 15 pounds on, throw 20 pounds on your back, and just go through your normal routine, and that's going to create a massive increase in your caloric demand for the day. Again, that's just practical, right? That's something that you can add to your routine that doesn't take any more time out of your regular routine. That's the kind of stuff that I absolutely love. So reason number five is gonna be kind of the flip side of the caloric burn, right? So we know that rucking does burn more calories than walking, but if you are an elite athlete, which I've used this now with two professional athletes, rucking can be a form of active recovery. So it can be movement throughout your week that kind of helps flush your system. It does keep you moving, but it's not gonna crush you. And so, you know, you can use rucking as active recovery. And like I said, I've done this now with two separate professional athletes and have had a lot of success with that as part of their rest day routine. Okay, reason number six that maybe you should consider rucking is that it can be a secondary activity. So kind of like I was talking about with the, you know, walking the dog or taking the kids for a walk in a stroller, your rucking routine might just be listening to an audiobook or even making phone calls. I make phone calls while I ruck every so often, and that's, again, just a nice way to multitask. So when you're lifting weights or training in the gym, that's pretty much the only activity you're doing. But rucking opens the door for some possible multitasking. Personally, I usually am listening to a podcast or listening to an audiobook while I ruck. I don't really listen to music when I train, but like I mentioned, sometimes that's a perfect time to sneak in a couple phone calls as well. You know, whether those are business calls or I'm just calling a friend to catch up, my boy Daniel Mogg, you might know what I'm talking about. Reason number seven why you should consider rucking. Rucking is done outside. And as we all know, we need to be outside more. So it gets you outside in your local neighborhood. It gets you outside in an awesome place to go for a walk. So getting out of your house, getting some vitamin D, or sometimes I'm doing it in the dark because it's too early in the morning. But regardless, like still getting that fresh air, still getting outside, still kind of exploring your neighborhood by foot. I think that is very, very underrated. Okay, so that's gonna wrap up today's topic. Those are seven reasons why I personally use rucking in my routine, why I encourage the Perform 24 family to ruck, and why you might find a lot of benefit in rucking yourself. Okay, if you like this video and you are into rucking, I would love for you to join our YouTube journey. Please hit that subscribe button. The next video that I'm going to be making is going to be a big comparison video between the rucksack that I've been using for the last year and a half. This is a very, very cheap bag, but I've put a lot of miles on it, and I have just upgraded it. Boom, okay, I've just upgraded it to the Rucker 3.0 from GoRuck. This thing still has the tags on it. I'm about to bust it out for the first time right now. But I'm gonna be doing a comparison video between a cheap bag that has been working to a much nicer and probably more comfortable bag. And then also kind of show you why this bag is a little bit different from like a really pro level hiking or rucking bag. Okay, so this guy is not mine. This is a super high-end Mystery Ranch bag. It's got an external aluminum frame on it. This thing is an absolute tank. Ironically, this one still has tags on it too. This one's not mine, so this will be the only time you see this bag. But I'm gonna kind of show you why I bought this one, how it compares to a super cheap bag, and then how it compares to like an actual professional grade rucksack. So that's what you can expect to see from the next couple videos. I've had a blast making these YouTube videos. I think I'm on like month five or almost six of consecutive weekly uploads, and I just love, you know, the interaction and kind of seeing what you guys are interested in. So I always appreciate you guys watching. Train hard, live full, and I'll see you in the next video. Let's go.